YouTube, what's good? It's your boy, Jay Anchor, holding it down again with Atmo, ready to react to this shit. Hit that shit.
Before creation itself, there were six singularities. Forged into infinity stones.
This is our first day here. We are in Pinewood, in Atlanta, and it's actually pretty unbelievable.
Day one of what promises to be a year of fun-filled lensing.
I remember actually going to see the first Avengers with one of my best mates from home, and I'd never have dreamed that I'd ever be in one of these movies, let alone playing Spider-Man. I feel like I'm on top of the world because this is just mind-blowing.
What we always try to do in our studios is we're building the cinematic universe, is look at the big picture, how can things relate across movies and across years. Avengers Infinity War is the culmination of the entire Marvel Cinematic Universe as started in May of 2008 with the release of Iron Man 1. And it really is an unprecedented culmination of a series of films interlinked together, which at the time had never been done before. And for us, the important thing is making it all come together. We know they're gonna face Thanos. We've been setting that up since Avengers 1. How do you do that in a way that is unexpected, that pits the Avengers against somebody who's more powerful than anyone they face, and yet make them completely unprepared to face him? Well, tear them apart, which is why we did Civil War before Infinity War.
As we were conceiving and executing Civil War, the end of that movie was very much a setup for what these movies would be. We always had that sense of that.
Tony is not talking to Steve. The Avengers are basically a name with nobody in it. The world is vulnerable.
Tony senses this greater threat approaching, and so he is doing everything in his power to keep you safe.
Thanos shows us why he's the biggest, the best, the baddest villain that we've ever had, and the most frightening villain that the Avengers have ever faced.
The most exciting part is the incredible roster of well-developed characters, and it's going to create a really combustible, exciting, massive-scale adventure.
You know that we're onto something within the studio when we hit upon an idea or we see a piece of concept art, and all of us in the room go, "This is cool." And in Avengers Infinity War, the Avengers will meet the Guardians of the Galaxy.
Because of what Marvel is, because of what they have done over the last 10 years, these next two Avengers films will be an event like no one has ever seen on film before.
Shit was golden. Like,
yeah.
Thanos, man, a beast. 10 times better than Apocalypse, I can tell you that much. I'm just saying, like, shit.
Now you throwing a shade, shit.
Right, I mean, like, you throwing these, like, people, that, I mean, you know, these characters, these villains are supposed to be, like, hard-ass bosses, but then they get to the final battle and they, like, die like bitches, like, damn. You know, you can't. Thanos ain't no damn bitch. Like, you know, that's why they got part one and part two. So you're gonna take some shit to take his ass down too.
Man, that's crazy. So to see them, bro, they already knew what they were doing from the jump. Like, that's proof. That's what was it? Go ahead and say the six P's. Go ahead.
Oh, proper preparation and practice prevents poor performance.
There you go. And there ain't no motherfucking poor performance in the Marvel Cinematic Universe because of every six P you just said, yeah. Bro. So
exactly.
We, man, and it's crazy because you've got Kevin Feige, who's actually like a fucking comic book nerd. Like, he's a nerd. Everybody that's working on that shit is a nerd. So they know what it feels like to really want something from it. Like when you watch an anime or you watch a cartoon or you read a comic, you usually put yourself in the situation of the hero. You usually exactly. see how you would want to do it, how it would go about if you were that person.
Right, yep.
So when you put that passion on yourself or wanting to just be in that situation in the comic book, in the movie, in the TV show, whatever, and then relate it to how you think it should go down in the cinematic universe, there's little room for failure.
Exactly,
because
yeah.
you use your brain to understand. Commitment to the idea, execute the idea, and trust that the idea that you have is golden.
Golden, yep.
So as you can see with Kevin Feige, man, he's been knowing what he was doing, and he's been putting his trust to each individual director for each movie.
Yeah.
And every last one of them have led up to things. Like, bro, like things that shouldn't have even worked out.
Still worked out.
That worked out. Like, freaking Ant-Man was one of them. Guardians of the Galaxy, definitely one of them, bro. Talking tree, that only said. Or a fucking raccoon running around with a Gatling gun and shit. Like, come on, bro. A freaking giant green alien that's very, very.
I think the fact that they're, like, so weird made it funny and, you know, different. You know, it's not like a Spider-Man. It's not like an Iron Man. These motherfuckers. Random ass motherfuckers coming together to fucking save
the and world. It worked because it was hella action, hella visuals, story, like all of that stuff combined together. So you can just see the passion that they put in the story for Guardians of the Galaxy, mm-hmm. Iron Man, how they made you get close to the characters.
Mm-hmm.
And now you got all of that coming together and we're just about to go fucking down in Infinity War. Even Civil War, it's just crazy to see. Like you sat there all of them years and watch everybody team up and fight, and then they gotta whoop each other's ass.
Yeah.
I was like, damn, this shit really hurt. Like, right, that shit. That motherfucker dropped it. He's like, that's my father's shield, and he dropped that shit on the ground.
Like, take this like, shit, bitch.
I was like, damn, bro, besties no longer. I was like, shit, they already had like a kind of bad kind of like they used to throw shade at each other, as you know, especially in. The first Avengers.
Oh, yeah,
they're like throwing hella shade, but they were still the team, though. It's just like, you're annoying, you're annoying, but we gotta work together. That shit went down.
Civil War, yeah, that was when they actually like started throwing the blows, and like
even,
actual blows.
And even in Marvel, I wouldn't even expect them to go that dark with it. Like, blood, and they was beating the shit out of each other.
You know, breaking people's arms off and shit.
Yeah. So, like, I'm curious if they're gonna bring that same. I know they're gonna bring that same kind of passion and strength to.
Oh yeah, they got to.
Because they know, like, I really can't see this movie fucking up at all. Like, there's nothing in my brain that.
I mean, it's Marvel.
Not only it's Marvel, but when you see them talk about it, you know that they're all sitting there at the table like, yo, this shit is fucking awesome. Like, this storyboard is crazy. Like, yo, look at these costumes. Like, oh my god, bro. Like, some of them. I like making the movie excited to finally watch that shit. That's the point. You gotta be making the movie as if you were sitting at the motherfucking stove about to make the bombest meal for your family. Like, yeah, it's all fun and games, but if you fuck it up, your whole family gonna be looking at you like, bro, this shit's nasty.
It comes down to producer, director, you know, actors, fucking lighting detail, fucking all this shit counts, bro.
Everything
counts. Sound, fucking scenery, cinematic shit, fucking camera here, camera there, making it, don't make it basic. Fucking make this shit dope. I learned that from you, actually.
I'm saying, bro, you gotta give it your all. You gotta make. If you got the opportunity to do it, you need to do it at the best to your ability, no matter what.
Yeah.
And that is what I believe Marvel is trying to do. And even that, they still have a plan after the Avengers. Like, they've got a success portfolio, like that shit that they need to go through, step A, step B, this is how we're gonna do it. We're gonna take left over here, right over here, we're gonna jump down over here, crawl up over
like
here.
Like, they got so many side stories or spinoffs they can do.
Mm-hmm.
Shit, dope,
and even then, when you wanna look over at their Netflix shows, bro.
Oh, yeah.
Like, that's another reason why I've been trying to get you to watch them, because, hey, bro, like, they're fucking Netflix shows. You don't really expect much from them. It's just like, oh, yeah.
Free
shows. You get the whole seasons on there, man. You sitting there watching that shit like, where the fuck I been?
That's probably how I'm gonna act.
Like, who's directing this? Who's the choreographer for all of this fighting? Like, damn. And the thing is the shows and on Netflix, they don't have to be as censored like they are in the movies. So in Daredevil, you got some shit going on in the Marvel Universe you haven't seen on screen because you got people dying, motherfuckers losing their heads and shit. Like, things are happening in the Marvel Universe that you aren't used to, which makes the story grab you in even more on the Netflix shows. Because you know you wouldn't see something as heinous as that in the actual cinematic universe, because, you know, there's children for what they're watching, so they can't really do something like that. And so I really hoping that the Defenders are some kind of way, like, the same way we didn't, bro, we did not expect Spider-Man to come back. Nah. We was, like, we was hoping, pleading, crying, selling some of our souls to Satan. We was throwing wishes in wells, rubbing genie bottles, doing everything under the motherfucking sun just to get Spider-Man back to Marvel. And when it happened, we were just like, nah, it's not, that's bullshit, that's all lies. Like, nobody wanted to believe that, and then they confirmed it. We were like, oh god, and we were just happy. So maybe the last thing we can wish for is for Marvel to just be king and just grab everything back. Fantastic Four, possibly even X-Men. I don't care. Within these next couple of years, they need to be trying to get everything that they own back, because they are the only ones who know how to treat that shit.
Right. I mean, slumpy ass Fantastic Four. That was like probably one of the worst movies that year. Probably one of the worst ever ish. I gotta look on the list, but it's down there somewhere.
But not even on the list.
Probably, yeah, you're so bad, you don't even get on the fucking list. God damn.
Nobody just wants to talk about you. You're just the ugly stepchild. Right. Just stay your ass over there at the corner of the cinematic universe.
But luckily, Michael B. Johnson had fucking Creed come after that fucking movie that same year.
Yeah, and that's good. Now he's gonna have a redemption because he's about to be in Black Panther. You already know Black Panther.
No, Michael B. Johnson.
Yeah, he's gonna be in Black Panther.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
I think he is the villain. Yeah, I think he's one of the villains, or the brother, or something. Somebody that's mad and salty, they ain't getting what they want. That's who he's playing.
Shit, he's gonna be throwing them hands, bro.
that's good, because I trust that. Like, bro, you know much about Black Panther? Like,
I mean, I know it's gonna be like, what they say, like 90-some% black people, and like it's gonna be
This is gonna change
Africa. But it's like this is completely different than any other movie.
Yeah, because this is just gonna change the world, bro. This is practically an entire black cast about a black civilization that is the richest and the smartest civilization on the face of this planet. A lot of people ain't gonna be ready for that shit, bro. They gonna come in there. They gonna enjoy it because it's got Marvel's title on it. But that's about to change the world. It's about to open some eyes, bro. It is about to open some eyes, because the whole entire lore of even the Black Panther himself, by I believe Stan Lee, or maybe somebody else, is harkening back to quote unquote the truth of the Egyptians and Imhotep, and the fact that blacks weren't always Neanderthals that's taking whips across their back. No, we were people at one point.
Yeah.
So to see that not only be portrayed in a superhero aspect, but a guy, do you know Black Panther is the richest superhero? Like, over Batman, over Tony Stark?
I didn't know that.
Any of them. Like, he is a black man who is African, is the richest superhero in all of any superhero created in both universes.
I didn't know that.
Yeah.
Damn, richer than Batman, richer than Tony. Damn.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Beautiful. I can't bore you. Everybody in their grandma.
And that's just from like, you know how people that get money and shit passed down from all their ancestors? Mm-hmm. Because of all the whole history and
everything. Is their entire lineage, like, the passed down of the Black Panther, the where they're located, the worth of the vibranium, all of that shit. Yeah.
Nice.
They, you know, these mobiles done been had weapons, then been had technology, then been had science, and they just chilled in their own little area. Where they even had a cloaking device over their entire city. There's a comic when, like, the white men find their city for the first time and shit. And they try to come up with guns and, oh, let's take them and take their shit, man. They weren't having it. Putin Tagata. Fuck out of here. Like, go, white man. Just be gone. Like, that shit was funny to me, man. So, like, well, you got to look at some of the lore of this stuff. It's amazing. So that's another reason why I believe that the MCU itself is just rich. And it's just going to be great.
Hey, man, I mean, shit, like, because they put out a list of all the movies that they're going to be having up until, what, 2021 or some shit, 20-something? And then going beyond that, is what you're saying, that they have a plan for what they're doing after that shit? Man, that's a lot of damn movies, bro.
That's a lot of work.
That's a lot of damn $10-$15 movie tickets, bro.
But here's the thing, bro. They are going to make their money back. They know it, man. They invested. Here's the thing. They didn't just invest in the characters. They invested in themselves to deliver the right kind of characters. Because it's like, oh, yeah, I want to do this whole plan, but, you know, I don't really know how I want to do this. And you go in there and making a movie, and then motherfuckers think that shit suck. Then you get low sales. Then nobody wants to go to see your next movie because you burn them and trust for the first movie, and then now you just nobody wants to fuck with you. No, DC. DC. Like, fuck, bro.
It always comes down to them. I mean, if Wonder Woman is hot, then we're going to bring it up again. Like, okay, they got that one, so can we, you know, we're going to keep going at it.
Like, because, yeah, when we were in the movie theater, like, I was telling you, and I was looking at the poster for Wonder Woman. I was just looking at the poster, and I was like, I can't believe this shit's really happening. Like, damn. Because when is the last time we haven't had a female standalone movie? Have we? That's in the superhero genre, like.
Nah, it's in, like, the DC Marvel.
Mm-mm, no, not a single one. And it's only right for the first one to be Wonder Woman, bro. So that's why
why they was holding out. Well, I mean, Marvel doing their own thing, but then I think Scarlett Johansson was trying to help.
She's not strong of enough character enough real story and enough ground to really maintain a standalone movie. Like Wonder everybody Woman. Knows who Wonder Woman is. Like, that's just, if you don't know who the fuck Wonder Woman is, then, like, who the fuck are you? Like, it's just how that is. So, when you see Wonder Woman on that poster, and she's just like this, and she's looking stronger than half of some of the cinematic men in the universe, you're just like, I really don't want them to fuck this movie up. Right. Like, because if they do, I don't even
that's
know.
It's going to be bad. Like, mad,
hell yeah, the females are gonna be mad. Like, damn, I'm gonna be mad. Shit, I don't care. I'm gonna be mad, man, because I've always wanted to see this, like, a strong female lead, and for Wonder Woman to be like, my mom loved Wonder Woman, all that shit. So, I want them to be able to really, really bring that. And after that, here's the thing. What I'm hoping is, I'm hoping their insecurity kind of reverse psychologizes and like reverse. On them, so say so you see how Batman v Superman went a certain way, and they're like, "Her, what do we do for Suicide Squad? What do we do? What do we do? What do we do? Change it, make it colorful."
From past movies to affect how they make future movies.
What if they're working with a certain thing for like Justice League, right? And then like Wonder Woman kills it, slay game on strong, right? And then they're just like, huh. Switch it up, guys!
Like, Cyborg coming out as wood or some shit. No, I'm just looking different than the trailers and shit.
Yeah. Like, and they actually did, like, okay, so that works. That works.
Right.
All right, let's go ahead and just, you know, make some changes to Justice League. Right. And then they if they're going to be insecure or in a certain way, they start making the right changes to the movies.
Yeah.
And then from there, in that kind of insecurity and failure, it grows confidence and strength in what they need to do going forward. Yeah. Because if they don't fucking come with it this year, this is 2017. As you've seen these movies all this year are about to be crazy. The movies we've seen so far, they have not let us down at all. Mm. This year we got remakes coming in. We got all kind of shit coming in. This is the year to get on the bandwagon of non-fuck-up. So if they don't bring their shit this year with the movies they have in this lineup, nobody's going to remember them, bro. Like, no one's going to give much of a fuck. Or they're just going to become that niche where you know you're going, it's just going to be garbage. And they don't want that on their reputation. Yeah. They don't need that on their reputation because it's just a slander to the DC universe, period. DC fans are going to be hurt. They're like, damn, yo, what are y'all doing with our people, our villains?
Exactly.
Like, y'all not showing no respect. All y'all doing is just throwing them around on screen and scared as fuck. With your directing activity, like, it's bad, man. I love DC's animated films way more than Marvel's animated films. Like, their animated, their TV shows are good, their animated films are great. But I'm like, Marvel's animated films aren't that great. And I think one of the only ones I actually seen that was great was Doctor Strange when it came out in 2009.
I like those Spider-Man.
Okay, okay, that's the TV show. That's just, that's the good shit. Okay. But I'm talking about like the animated movies.
Oh, animated movies.
Like
okay.
the long yeah, movies yeah, and stuff. Yeah, yeah. Like that Marvel, that they yeah. just, they,
TV, yeah, TV.
It's not real good at okay. all. It's not at all.
Animated movies. Yeah, you got a point on that.
So at the end of the day, man, I'm trying to like, I'm excited for both. I'm excited to see at one point maybe DC can tighten the fuck up, stand stern, and just move forward, and that Marvel just continues to surprise us with their passion and their strength to give us an act. Like, real, bro, when I see these movies, you know how you usually like think how shit should go? Like, a character should look this way, a character should sound this way, a character should have this mm-hmm. kind of power. Marvel kind of like eases your brain by doing that. Like when Thor
comes, they have stuff that yeah, like yeah. fit versus trying to force shit.
When Thor comes on screen, you like, I feel like that's how Thor would sound. Mm-hmm. I feel like that's how Thor would look.
Even though it was like they had one Thor, and they had like three different Hulks and shit.
Yeah, like that's the only thing yeah. I will have. I'm glad you yeah. brought that up because that pissed me off.
Because they had three different Hulks.
Three different Hulks, but then Mark Ruffalo ended up being a pretty great Hulk. Now the iterations of the Hulk pissed me off because
how he looked. Like,
yeah, because a lot of people didn't like Ang Lee's Hulk, which was way back, the real big green soft.
Oh yeah, 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 yeah.
But here's the thing: when you look up the lore and you understand the powers of who Hulk is, he was the most accurate. When he took damage, his muscles increased. He ran at over 300 miles an hour, jumped at over 3 to 4 miles in range. Motherfucker was catching missiles out the sky, like sonic booming and all that extra stuff, digging and swimming. He's swimming through concrete and jumping out the ground. And then in the second one, the Incredible Hulk, like we didn't get to see him showcase that many powers. We didn't get to see him fly.
Like, people complain about that. They're like, why is he like jumping high and shit?
Because them the idiots don't know who the Hulk yeah. is. Like, how do you, like, there's a lot of, and I'm talking about some actual Hulk fans still talk shit about the Ang Lee Hulk. But when you look at his stats, you can go into the Marvel Encyclopedia, look anywhere, Wikipedia, I don't give a fuck. You can look at the Hulk stats, and it tells you who he is, what he does, and how he works. From his gamma radiation, his yep. muscle recellular generation, his speed, all of that stuff. How his anger increases his strength over time. And one thing that fucking caught me in the Avengers that took me out of the movie was when he was getting gunned down by the Chitauri. He was like, and then he hunched up, and you actually see a Hulk bleed purple out of his nose. I was like, if that were Ang Lee's Hulk,
then that would
that nigga would have been. He would have just jumped up and probably just started smacking everybody. He would have gotten more angry. Everybody would have. He would have gotten more angry. He would have increased in size and would have just probably. He could have. That Hulk could have jumped out of New York and probably went to like New Jersey, but like he could have jumped out
to vacation shit.
Yeah, jumped in the fucking Bahamas, jumped off the border and went to damn Canada for all he wanted to. And that was one thing that bothered me about the Hulk. And so apparently in Thor Ragnarok, they're supposed to be doing the Hulk.
Yeah,
they're supposed to be bringing the Hulk and doing the whole Planet Hulk stuff. And that's a whole another story for a whole another video with extra shit in it. But I want them to, even if all they gotta do is just slide that kind of lower end to the Hulk. They ain't gotta,
yeah,
like,
they ain't
just like just start seeing him running over 300 miles an hour. Just start seeing him jump 3 to 5 miles. Start seeing him, somebody tries to cut him, like he will take some damage, but it's just gonna regenerate and that very muscle is just gonna increase in size. Like, that's actually how the human body works. After the muscle tissue tears, it rebuilds itself in even bigger fashion to adapt to the damage that it just took, like a fucking Super Saiyan. Mm-hmm. So that's what I need them to do with Hulk, and everything be okay. Everybody else so far is fucking good. I just don't need the Hulk bending down on his knee, whining and shit when he's taking bullets, because that's not the Hulk, bro. That has never been the Hulk.
Baby back bitch.
Yeah, that is, Hulk is not a baby back bitch at all. And I need them to let these motherfuckers know that. Because like, I will always love that Ang Lee Hulk, man. When I saw that as a kid, when he was fighting them dogs, the motherfucking dog bit him on the dick. Oh, his damn dick muscles grew. Like, what kind of shit is that? The dog, and his shit said, and then he like, I don't know if he like, what he did to the dog, but he was like, the dog bit him on the shoulder. And what did his fucking shoulder muscle do? it fucking, his muscles on his shoulder grew and broke the fucking dog's jaw.
Damn.
That's what I'm talking about.
Different,
bro. That's the Hulk that I know. That's the Hulk that I read about. Like that, you don't see that shit no more. And because they kept changing him, that was the only problem that I had. And they wanted to talk about, oh, the Hulk may not be the kind of character that you can have, hold, a standalone movie. I mean, the only problem would be the CG and the amount of money it would take to maintain the Hulk on the screen. Other than that, they know we love the Hulk, bro. If you know we love the Hulk, you know you're going to get your money back. So just do the damn thing. That's all I'm saying.
You know, they always, I mean, they listen to the fans, but then they sometimes let the fans get to them too much to where they fuck up, you know, what could have been.
To be honest, I don't know what happened. I don't know why I think it just failed because of the time that it came out, you know? Because back then,
the first one came out, like, it was right after the first couple of Spider-Mans. Like, Spider-Man came out, like, 2001, 2002, 2004-ish. And then the first one came out, I think the first Hulk came out, like, 2006.
Yeah, it was old, though. But, and it was around that time, I guess, where people were like, yeah, nobody gives a fuck about comic books. Everybody and their grandma now. Right. Even old people, everybody and their grandma are bowing down to these damn superhero comic book movies. Like,
exactly.
And then X-Men was probably the hottest one out at that time. And then when Spider-Man came out, bro.
Tobey Maguire and shit.
And no one will forget that scene where Spider-Man was in that flaming house, bro.
Yeah.
Green got me.
Yeah.
That nigga was dope. Woo. Woo. I was in the movie theater like,
happy ass.
That shit was crazy, bro. Yeah. The whole movie theater stood up and was like, what? Like, and I swear, like, half of them weren't even probably comic book fans. Yeah. But to see me, Spider-Man being my favorite, I was like, yo, he doing his thing in this movie. But everybody else was raving in the theater, man. They were wild. And that was a good feeling to see somebody, see people around you enjoy the same things that you enjoy for the same reasons. And that's why the Marvel Cinematic Universe has been doing so well. Because they just... And that was just Sam Raimi's Spider-Man. That was a different iteration. This is in the hands of Marvel King right now. Tom Holland? That Spider-Man, yo. I can't wait to see what they do.
He did a wonderful job in Civil War too, man. His debut, that was dope.
I can't wait to see what they do with him, man. And I hate it when I go into the comments, right? And the ignorant people are like, another Spider-Man movie. Another reboot. What the fuck is Marvel doing? And they had no clue what's going on behind the scenes. They have no clue how hard Marvel fought to get him back.
They're just being all bitchy.
They have no clue how accurate this Spider-Man is about to be. When I was working in the movie theater, at the end of Civil War, when it did, like, the Spider-Man will return, I could hear the people in the audience, another Spider-Man? Like, really? They're starting it over? Who's this kid now? I'm like, little do you fucking know.
They all were sharing the fucking new fucking mom, fucking Aunt May, yeah. That was a Civil War. That was looking hot. Everybody, yeah. Mom was fucking standing up for that shit. Doing a little whistle sound that I can't even do it, but you know that shit.
They was like, you're kind of young to be on.
Right. Like Tony Stark banging that shit. Like, they were saying all that dumb shit, bro. Like. There's some clowns.
That's exactly what they were saying in the theater, though. But
clowns, though.
I can't wait, man. Iron Spider, all of these people are about to just... Like, the dopamine in my brain just talking about this going off right now is just like... I feel like I'm that kid again, bro. I feel like I'm that kid again. And that kid who didn't even know none of this was coming. Like, this is like the perfect presents underneath the Christmas tree. You were so poor, you didn't think you could get presents, and then you actually come out the motherfucking living room, and there's a nice bundle of presents. Yeah. That's what I feel like when it comes to Marvel. So, hey, that's what I feel like.
Cool. Alright, guys, if you like this reaction, post your comments down below. Like, share, and subscribe to this channel for more reaction videos. J Anchor out!